In this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to telebridge. I'm going to go over the requirements for telebridging, as well as a movement and aim, and at the end where and how you should practice it. I'm going to go over the 5-block tele, since it's the most basic and easy version, and it's very helpful to know how to do it if you want to go to different telebridge methods like speed tele, which I'll not show you right now, cause I haven't really mastered it, and I don't feel like I can make a tutorial on it. But before I start, make sure to subscribe, just clicking a button helps me out more than you think. Anyway, I hope you enjoy. So the requirements are quite simple. You basically have to be able to long drag click at least 20 CPS consistently, and you have to be able to move your mouse while drag clicking. These things should be no problem for people who have been drag clicking for a long time, but if you just started, it might be hard. Also, 20 CPS is like the minimum I would say to get consistent. Don't try too hard to get like 40 CPS while bridging, because it will not help and it will be harder to concentrate on a movement which is way more important than the CPS. If your mouse can't drag click, don't worry, I have a lot of videos about drag clicking mice. The most popular mice at the moment for drag clicking are rocket mice, glorious mice, bloody mice, and a lot more. But the most important thing you need is patience. Telebridging takes a lot of time to learn and get consistent at. After watching this video, you might know how to do it, but there's no way you're going to get a full tele on the first day. For the average human, it takes about 6 weeks to build up muscle memory, which means about 6 weeks to be able to get a full tele almost every attempt. But of course, some people learn it faster or slower than others. The movement is one of the most important things about telebridging. It is often underestimated how important it is. When you jump off the island, you want to turn around and press S to go backwards. I'll go over the aim later, so let's just skip to the turn. Oh, also, you have to jump twice every tele. As you can see, I'm just holding my spacebar for this jump, so you don't really have to worry about it. When you're getting to the end of your 5-block tele, you have to start turning around. While you're turning, you want to press your D key. If you turn around the other way for telebridge, it will be the A key. And when you have turned over 90 degrees, you can press your W key. By the way, it doesn't really matter which way you turn, pick the one that's the easiest for you. Also, you don't have to press D before W, it really depends on how fast you turn, and some people don't even do it, like this guy. Make sure you're always sprinting, because otherwise there's no reason to turn around at all. As you can see, I use toggle sprint, which makes it the easiest in my opinion. If you don't use toggle sprint, I recommend pressing your sprint key at all times. At the exact moment I land, I tap space. As you can see, I'm also pressing W and A or D while sprinting, which makes it so I jump forward around 3 blocks, so I'm ready for the next tele. Some people also hold their spacebar, like Battle Snoop. This is slower, but it is possible. For me, it's actually harder to hold space, but for some people it might be easier. Okay, so at this point, you just have to repeat. Turn around again and you can let go of W. As you can see, I'm still holding D until I'm done turning around. But this is of course not necessary, like I said earlier. And now you can just repeat all of these steps. For some teles, you can see that I correct myself with my A key, and I'll explain it later when we get to the A. Okay, so now the aiming. It doesn't really matter if you aim on the top of the block or on the side. I do it on the side, but definitely not everyone does. The only difference is that when you aim on the top, you will have to aim down more, because you have to end up somewhere here at the end of the tele. There's no better way. With enough practice, they can both be the same consistency. When you start placing blocks, you want to aim down slowly. If you don't aim down enough, you won't place the last block and you will most likely fall off. The same thing happens when you aim down too much. I can't really say how much aim down, because you are not going to be looking at the courts while telebridging, so you'll just have to find out yourself. You also don't want to aim down too fast, because then the block simply won't place. To turn, you don't want to turn 180 degrees, you want to turn around 135 degrees, because you are pressing W and D, which means if you turn around 180 degrees, you will jump next to your telebridge, but you're never going to turn exactly 135 degrees. As I said earlier, I sometimes correct myself with the A key. I do this when I don't turn around enough. It might also happen that you turn around too much, and then you will have to turn less the next tele, or as I said earlier, you will fall off. But I can assure you that you will have full control over time. When I tele, I don't even realize that I'm pressing my A key to correct myself. I do it automatically. So to practice telebridging, a bridging server is the best option. My personal favorite one is MCPlayHD, but there's a lot of other servers like Grief and Bridgerland. The benefit of a bridging server is a start. You always spawn in the same spot, which makes it so you can press W and space at the same time to land in the perfect spot to start telebridging. On MCPlayHD, you have a normal and a short mode. And to start, it is also the best to go to the short mode, because obviously you have to do less teles. But also on normal mode, you have to switch stacks of blocks, because it takes more than 64 blocks to telebridge to the end, which will be hard to do because you've just started learning this bridging method. On short it is 5 teles, and on normal it is 9 teles with a single block ledge, if you do full 5 block teles obviously. And that's about everything. I hope you enjoyed. If I helped you, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I wish you a good luck in practicing. Bye!